train arriving shortly. Southbound.
Hi guys, and welcome back to some more Watch Dogs Online hacking. I just thought I'd add a bit of commentary to this video, because without it, it might be a little bit boring. As you can see, we've got a suspected camper up here. To be honest, I don't think the multi-story car parks are the best places to camp in the game. There are ways to get the hack, which is what I'm attempting to do now, obviously. As you can see, he's got proxy IEDs placed upstairs, and from the distance marker you can see he's not too far away, just 14 meters there, so he's just trying to get that hack symbol to pop up. I think he must be pretty much a noob at this type of thing, but he can still catch me. As you can see, I still can't quite get the angle. I really don't want to go through the door, so in a minute you're going to see me get the grenade launcher out. Just try and blast him out of his hidey hole. Finally managed to do it, and then just already decided I'm gonna, as he's camped in here, I'm just gonna try and play out the hack inside multi-story car park. Probably one of the easiest places to do that, and one of my favorite tactics is just to sort of hide behind one of these ramps, basically, because that way you've got you can go up or down, really, as long as they don't come around behind the ramp themselves. If I'm on a bike, I'll always check behind those ramps if someone's invading my game. But yeah, no, I think this is where I decide to just camp myself. I could have made the more hacking more interesting. I could have destroyed some cars, driven around beeping the horn, but to be honest, as I went to the effort of hacking his phone, and I think there's some good points on offer, but I can't quite remember. I just thought I'd camp. And just to stop it being boring, I thought I'd add commentary as well. And hopefully you'll still be able to hear if he's getting near. To be honest, he's one of those campers that, as soon as I've got the hack, until the end of the video, he's pretty much searching the wrong places or just hasn't got a clue, which is another reason why I think he's a bit of a noob that's just taken up camping to get some points. Anyway, as I'm talking, just wanted to say thank you to anyone that has been watching a few of these videos lately on my daily hack series. If you have watched a few, you know I'm doing daily hacks up until the release of Watch Dogs 2, so they will stop on the 14th of November. But yeah, I can tell there's probably about 20 people at least viewing daily. I don't know if it's the same people, but if you are one of those, thank you. I appreciate it. It was just a fun little experiment to see if people would tune in daily. I know it can't be much fun when there's no commentary. I'd love to add more commentary. I just don't get the time to record it live much, but I will try to do some more. And every day is, you know, if you have been watching a few of these videos, you probably know I've just been recommending a different video every day. Some of my more creative ones, or just ones with really, really good hacks on. And Yeah, so instead of adding it on the screen today, I'll just shout it out. If you fancy watching another video, I would recommend online dance hacking. I've done a few now where, just to really troll the target, I just tried to dance along as if I was listening to music during the hack, and it's just funny watching them trying to catch you when you're just messing around and not taking the hack that seriously. And yeah, just check it out if you fancy watching a silly hack, and just see if I'm successful. It's also quite funny watching the players when, if they do come across you, they just don't know what to do because they're just moving around erratically and they're just wondering why.
I needed that.
Yep, and as you can see, yeah, it was good points on offer there. So yeah, he was no way near at the end. So yeah, terrible camper, terrible location, and good win for me. And then this guy, I often come across these guys that are in the gun shop down by the crafting area, and a lot of the time they're usually buying guns, so you've got a small window when you can attack them or hack their phone. But this guy was actually inside the shop, just apparently AFK, but then I saw him move. So I thought, sod it, I'm just gonna buy some, well, top up my ammo, but it was actually topped up already. Hacked his phone. And then in a minute, just get the sniper rifle out.
Get him! Now's our chance!
I'm still aware that they didn't seem completely AFK, so I was a bit cautious here, but I couldn't resist. And yep, then they spring back to life, and it's game on. And now it's just jammed into a bit of a traffic hack, as I recall. And I'm going to leave this one to play out.
Oh,
vicious. Not intentional.
Yeah,
so thanks once again if you've been watching some of these daily hacks. I will be trying to add commentary on at least a couple more videos before the series ends. Ideally, I'd like to do some live commentary, especially on the last video, but we'll just see if I get the time. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.
All right.
Come on, man.